Hello, I'm T. Maxwell Smith and welcome to myDSLR, the show that teaches you how to use your DSLR. Ooh, logo. DSLR 101. This is basically my beginner's guide to pro photography, which means we're going to go in depth into the basics. And essentially, this is the first class for DSLR 101, and where better or worse to start than ISO. Okay, ISO is probably the thing that I'm asked most about by photographers or people learning to use their DSLR, and the questions usually being, what is the ISO and what's it for? So hang on to something, we're going to go deep into this one. Learning photography, we need to understand there is one key ingredient, light. The question is, how much light do we need? Now, that sounds like a simple question and it should have a simple answer, but it's a little complicated. What we need is called an exposure. Not that sort of exposure. Exposure in photography is light multiplied by time. Now, I'm not expecting you to understand this straight away. We're going to talk about exposure in the next couple of videos, but what we're after is an exposure. That's an amount of light and it's light multiplied by time. Okay? Now, light and time, in stating the obvious, are two different things. Now, like different species, they don't multiply very well. In comes ISO. ISO stands for International Standards Organization. And all that is a group of people who came up with a measurement of light sensitivity. So ISO is a measurement of light sensitivity, but it's measured in fractions of a second. So ISO is a measurement of light that's measured in time, fractions of a second. The ISO actually sets how much light we need in order to take a photo. It determines how sensitive the image sensor is to light. Now, the more sensitive your camera is to light, the less light you need in order to take a photo. So, the ISO normally starts at 100, and then it doubles to 200, which is twice as sensitive as 100, and then it doubles to 400, which is twice as sensitive as 200, and it kind of goes on to some pretty phenomenal numbers depending upon your camera. Now, the thing to remember is, the more sensitive your camera is to light, the less light you need to take a photo. Or put another way, the more sensitive your camera, the lower lighting conditions in which you can take photos. ISO was created in order to make an exposure. Okay? It was made to tell you how much light you need in order to take a photo. So I'm gonna talk about exposure for a bit. Not that sort of exposure. So if you don't understand this straight away, that's okay. I'm gonna put this clip into a video a little bit later on that summarizes exposure and ISO. But ISO sets how much light we need for correct exposure. And we can actually test this, okay? You can test this with your camera. But we need to remember a few things first. Firstly, we're gonna need to remember a number. And that is 16. Okay, so that's going to be pretty easy to remember. So, next we're going to need to think about a time. And that is 12 noon. Again, not so complicated. So, lastly, we're going to need to remember a lighting condition. And that is sunny. So let's use these things to really test our ISO. So, outside, on a sunny day, at 12 noon, you can set your aperture, or f-stop, to 16, and your ISO will match your shutter speed. So, if you have an ISO of 100, your shutter speed needs to be 100. Okay, I'm going to say that again because it really is that simple. Outside, on a sunny day, at 12 noon, With an aperture of f16, your ISO will match your shutter speed. If your ISO is 400, your shutter speed needs to be 400. If your ISO is 800, your shutter speed needs to be 800 for correct exposure. If your ISO happens to be 1600, your shutter speed should be, you guessed it, 1600. Now that's just a standard rule that they call Sunny 16. So essentially, all we need to remember is the ISO is a setup for how much light we need in order to take a photo. It sets up how much light we need for a correct exposure. So when there's not a lot of light, you need a higher ISO. Something like 800, 1600, or even 3200, or 6400, 12,800. Some of the numbers do get pretty high. But it's no wonder cameras boast those high ISO numbers. Those super high numbers mean you can take photos in darker conditions. But with great ISO comes great responsibility, because your ISO measures sensitivity. And sensitive cameras are like sensitive people. For example, if I were to say a joke, something like, "Why does the chicken cross the road?" A sensitive person would say,
"Is the chicken free range? This has to be politically correct, you know."
It's crossing the road. Clearly, it is free range. And it's going to get hit by a car anyway. What does it matter?
Oh, what a horrible joke. That's not funny.
Yes, like sensitive people, sensitive cameras make too much noise. But this all depends on the camera and the sensor. It's best just to test your camera, test the ISO, find out what level of noise really works for you. But don't push it too far, because just pumping the ISO means there will be a lot of noise in your photos. And noise is not a photographic technique. It is ugly photography. So let's summarize what we need to remember from this episode. First up, our ISO sets up how much light we need in order to take a photo. Secondly, the ISO is measured in fractions of a second at f16 on a sunny day. All we need to remember there is sunny 16. And lastly, test your camera's high ISO for possible image noise. So I have a lot more ideas for videos on how to make your photography better, but they're only going to come online as long as you folks want them to come online. So let me know you want to see more by clicking the subscribe button in the top of the screen, and remember to give a thumbs up if you like the video. Okay, so as always, until next time, happy shooting. Not that sort of shooting.